Hi, welcome to this Penn Publishing Interactive video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add a subdomain in the Plesk control panel. You might need a subdomain if you're trying to develop a new website. So for instance, you could put dev. Your top level domain, or if you have a different program that you're developing, say a calculator. So it could be calculator.yourdomain. So let's get started. So I'm already logged into my Plesk control panel here. In this video, I am using Plesk Onyx 17.8. Your interface might look a little different depending on when you're watching this video, but for the most part, the process is gonna be the same. So the first thing you want to do is go to add subdomain. You click on that and then you can type in whatever you want the subdomain to be. For instance, for this video, I'm gonna use test.penpubtutorials.com. Again, this can be calculator dot, this can be anything you want it to be that's descriptive for what you're trying to accomplish. So if you're developing a new website, maybe that's dev dot your top level domain. So currently, before I create this, I want to show you what shows up if someone were to go to test.penpubtutorials.com. So if someone goes there, there's nothing there, doesn't know what to do with this because there's no files, there's no connection, there's no DNS records for it. So once you create the type in the subdomain you want, Plesk is gonna create a document root, a root folder where you can keep all your files for this project or this website. In this situation, it's gonna be test.penpubtutorials.com. There's a couple of other settings here that I'm not gonna worry about in this tutorial. And then once I'm ready to go, I just hit okay. Plesk has created the subdomain for me in my account. In my account, I have a top level domain and a few other subdomains. So I'm gonna scroll down here to find it. And there it is. Again, right now, if someone were to go to this URL, this is what they would get. So the next step in the process is to add DNS records to make sure that this subdomain points to the proper files on this server. So you will want to copy this IP address because you're gonna need it when you update your DNS records. If you are a Penn Publishing Interactive partner, you're logging into your account, this is what it looks like. You will want to go under Domains, Manage DNS. If you are not a Penn Publishing Interactive partner, you can create an account with us. Just go to penpublishing.com and you can get information there. But if you have the Plesk environment at your host, you need to figure out where you manage your DNS. Again, in this demo, I'm gonna walk through the Penn Publishing interface for our partners. So, and here is the Penn Pub Tutorials zone file. So again, mine says penpubtutorials.com because that's the domain I'm working with. Yours can be, make sure that you're working with the one that you just created a subdomain for. Then you're just gonna hit edit zone. Once you do that, we're gonna add an A record with the test.penpubtutorials.com information. Now remember, copy the IP address. Go back and I'm gonna hit add record. I'm gonna type in test, and this has to match whatever you type in here has to be the same text that you typed in to be the subdomain. So for us, again, it's test.penpubtutorials. If you're calculator dot whatever your domain is, make sure you put calculator here. Next, you're gonna select a record. I'm gonna change the TTL to 3600, and then here where it says our data, I'm going to paste the IP address from Plesk. And then I'm gonna hit add record. Once I do that, it's gonna add my record to the DNS zone file, which you can see here. And make sure that you hit the save changes button. If you don't, this won't take effect. So I'm gonna hit save changes. And changes have been saved successfully. So now I am going to come over here and I am going to just reload this page. And there it is. You should be able to see the default Penn Publishing Interactive hosting page. Again, depending on who your host is, this might be a little different, but that tells me that the DNS resolved to the subdomain. And that's it. That's how you add a subdomain in Plesk control, in the Plesk control panel. Hope this video has been beneficial. For more information about PIM publishing, visit us at pimpublishing.com. If you are on Facebook and Twitter, we'd love for you to follow and like our page. And if you are watching this on YouTube, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you, and until next time.